Notre Dame against another Big East team, this time though at home, but needing a win just the same. Hey, how are you folks? Jason Horowitz, glad to be with you here on CBSSports.com. This time it's the UConn Huskies coming off a bye, coming into South Bend to take on Notre Dame. Let's bring in CBS Sports' Spencer Tillman to break this down. And Spencer, for the last few weeks, and it is the same this week, it's more about the coach than it is about the game. What do you expect of the future of Charlie Weiss at Notre Dame? He says that his future hasn't been decided yet. He doesn't think. What do you think?
Well, I don't think they're going to make a decision for the next couple of weeks. I think it would be the height of hubris for them to decide that without having someone in their gun sights right now or already having talked to someone with a reasonable expectation that that person would be the next coach at Notre Dame. That's the kind of thinking that got Notre Dame in the position that they're in right now. Notre Dame needs to understand where they are on the food chain of college football sports right now, and it's been at least 15 good years before they have been a, quote, classic Notre Dame team. So they've got a lot of hunting and searching to do before they fire Charlie Weiss, although certainly by the numbers at a point, was it 583, Jason, you and I were talking off camera about it.
Yeah.
It's exact same winning percentage that his predecessors had, Bob Davey and, of course, Ty Willingham. So if they did it, it wouldn't be without premeditated cause.
Yeah, no, that's true. You know, you're bringing up the winning percentage. They're paying him a lot more than they're actually getting production-wise. They're paying more for getting the same is what they did.
That's right.
Let me ask you this about his players, because it's got to be a tough situation week in, week out to be asked about this, and they've had losses. Do you think that they're just losing to better football teams, or this is actually becoming a distraction?
No, it's becoming a distraction, I think. You know, one of the first places you look to, Jason, to see if a team is really playing up to its potential is on defense. And I'm still scratching my head trying to figure out how, with the recruiting classes they've had over the last 3 years in particular, John Tenuta, their defensive coordinator, is not getting more out of that defensive unit. Now, again, Clausen, their quarterback, is playing exceptionally well, and he's got a running back that's been keeping him in the game. The receivers have been doing a great job, although they had a big injury that knocked out one half of their wide receiver duo. I think that their defense is what's surprising me, and I think it is impacting. I saw it with Oklahoma against Nebraska. You know, we saw it with a couple of teams that are struggling down the stretch. Saw it with LSU, who against La Tech was not their same team that played Alabama even in a loss a couple of weeks prior. So look at the defensive side of the ball. It will tell you a lot about a team, and I think Notre Dame's is telling us a lot.
Yeah, absolutely, and UConn is at a bye week to get ready and try to prepare to attack this Notre Dame team. And, Spence, you talk about the Huskies. It's been a few weeks since the death of Jasper Howard and the tough losses that they had on the football field. The last minute to West Virginia, the last minute loss to Rutgers, and then the tough game on national TV where they came up 2 points short at Cincinnati. Now they've had the bye week. Now they get ready. Do you think they come into South Bend and knock off the Irish?
Boy, I tell you what, it would be a bit of irony if they were able to do that, because no one expected UConn to be the team that would essentially maybe, possibly, be a knockout punch for Charlie Weiss, but they're in that unique position. I think Jordan Todman, their running back, is going to be the key for them. If they can get him going, you know, together with his backup, they've got over 1,500 yards rushing. I think they stand a fighter's chance. Again, that combined with the emotional downturn that we see at Notre Dame, I think UConn does have a chance.
Do you think they have a chance? Are you going to say they win? Are you going to put them in the victor circle here?
No, I'm going to go with Notre Dame winning it slightly, but it's going to be a very dramatic, and they're going to need every bit of the luck of the Irish to get this done, and they will get it.
Well, it wouldn't be any different than any other game they've played this season. So, with the exception of maybe Nevada at the beginning part of the year. Spencer T., thank you very much, sir. We'll talk to you soon.
All right, Jason, we'll see you.
All right, folks, for more on this game, stay right here with CBSSports.com. That'll do it for the College Football Preview Show, presented by Tyson. Any Tizers, the meaty good man snack. For Spencer Tillman, I'm Jason Horowitz. Take care, folks.